long-time church goers, long-time members, long-time followers of the Lord. But can you remember the first time you heard about it? The first time you encountered undeniable love from God? The first time you felt the grace of God in the power of God? The first time you experienced the miracle of God? How can we give this to the love of God and allow it to repair the world? Is it even possible? I see it firsthand, I've heard of it firsthand. I've seen it in this congregation's radical hospitality and welcome. I've seen it in the faces of people in Skid Row among the largest hospice population in America. I've seen it in the living rooms of hospice as the family gathers for those final moments. I've heard it in the stories of queer and trans people finding healing and redemption and reconciliation. I've experienced it in prayer circles among immigrant and migrant people as they shared how God protected them through their journey. I've heard it in the stories of women who gained equity and justice and liberation. I've heard it in the stories of my black and brown and indigenous people of color to see love, agape love. It's not only possible, but it is slowly healing the entire world. But I also believe that our humanity, our churches, must participate in such things. How can the world know about this inclusive, radical, and hospitable love without us? We are of this world. We are in the grocery stores, in the restaurants, in the schools, in our neighborhoods. We are in our jobs, among the people, among the society. We are the ones who are tasked with being witnesses of this accomplishment. Sometimes we lose our way and we need Jesus to call us back. I received a call a couple weeks ago from Churchwide. If you don't know what Churchwide is, it's our church headquarters. It's still today in Chicago. And this friend sits alongside the national suicide bishop of the entire thing, the one that keeps the entire ELCA. 10,000 copies. The church is in crisis. Those were the words of the Lord. We have 7 seminaries across the nation and only 6 students enrolled for the fall. We have 4 seminaries and students enrolled for the fall. The ELCA has 16,000 black people. 500 of those are retired, and more to come. There are more churches to come. Our current pastor needs to share the ministry to empower others to be served, especially young people. How else will they face a college ministry if they are not practicing the ministry? Now that is a sound of trouble. But when it's more trouble in the Bible, doing the hard work of engaging young young people, young families, people of color, the queer community, and this generation of humans who have preconceived notions of the church and its leaders. And I, for one, completely understand these dynamics. Why to love, why to be witnesses of God's love through Jesus, why we must act as shepherds in this world. Because you do realize that Jesus said to Peter, feed my people. In the ancient Greek, bosco, which means to feed, to nourish spiritually. And the word koimaino, which means to supervise, to guard, and to guide. So be your people gathered by the divine to respond to the Christ and injustice. We who have been formed and collected to be the witnesses of God's adopted love. Do many different things by day. But our true calling as students of Jesus is to be shepherds, to nourish, to guide, to guard, to love our people. Let this be our starting point, dear church. Our first task as shepherds is to demonstrate agape love to one another, to be concerned for the well-being of those don't be in this room today. Willing to think of others besides ourselves, to prioritize world preservation. After all, remember, it is the highest form of love. Use the faith to love and go be a witness of adopting love, for we remain to love. Biological necessity that is divinely summoned, the flow that is between the repair of this world. And we've been invited into that flow with our measure of love. Let us go, we are not enough. Word of God.